Welcome back, guys. You're still watching The Spot, and you're right on time for our spot of music. And today we have Emma Naira featuring Patu Ranking with For Your Matter. Almost everything Patu Ranking does, like, so. And like you said, he added his own sort of
vibe
and flavor to the song. But it's a nice video. Is it a heist? Are they stealing stuff?
Yeah.
Just when we need dollars too. They went and they took everything.
Yes.
So they stole, and then what
happened? America.
Well, you kind of have to watch the video to find out. If I told you everything, I'd be ruining it.
So is it like a Bonnie and Clyde theme?
Yeah. Bonnie and Clyde.
Yeah. Because, you know, the Bobo won't die for her matter. So clearly he's doing anything she wants him to do.
And there's so many placements in this
Product placements.
Yeah. I'm happy that Emma Naira is back. I'm happy that she's doing her thing. Yeah. And I really do hope that this year is her year. Like,
she's very hardworking. And she's fun.
And she's lucky.
I remember
she's
when
nice.
She was on the show. Yeah. She was so fun on the show when she came.
There's traffic. How are you guys going to escape?
Isn't it interesting that she jumped over the door into the seat?
And he opened the door. He's a gentle guy.
He's like, I'm not about to hurt myself.
Yeah, he's a gentle guy. Yeah. Good one. Nice little video.
But she's
nice
very athletic,
song.
Actually. Yeah, that's
true. She is. Yeah.
So it probably was nothing for her. Nice video. Like you said, hopefully she does more things this year.
Yeah.
Patu Ranking is already doing a lot of things this year, and hopefully he continues as well. Mm-hmm. It'd be nice to see her do more solo stuff.
More solo stuff?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, especially now that she's on her own.
Yeah, so. She's independent.
Yeah.
Right. Nice.
Naira Nation.
Love it. Yes. Nice video, Nation. Nice song.
Yeah.
Definitely a good song, member.
Definitely. Even without Patu Ranking, it was nice.
Yes, yeah. It was.
Yeah.
Okay. Wish her all the best.
Yes, indeed. Okay, so time for us to introduce our guest of the day. She's a writer and she's a spoken word artist. Yes, indeed. Please welcome Sheila Udofia.
Welcome, Sheila.
Hi, Sheila.
Welcome. In the cute suit. Love it.
Hi. Welcome to the show.
Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good. Hey.
I really like you.
I'm not sure you want to come in or...
I'm trying to figure out where to sit, actually.
Oh, no. Yeah, it's fine.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm aware it's a big house. There's so many seats, but just make
welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Yes. So, spoken word is... Zainab is a big spoken word fan. I like it as well. She's a huge, huge fan. Yeah. But it's something that I think in Nigeria, people are still kind of, unless you know it and you know what I mean? Like, it's not something that a lot of people are like, oh yeah, I really love spoken word. They have to learn to love it. So how did you get into it and sort of start really expressing yourself that way?
I actually think I don't know. I started by chance, to be honest. Okay. I've been writing for a while, and a few friends of mine used to go to this spot called Bogobiri.
Yes.
So they used to go for like open mic events.
Yeah.
And so I went there and I saw like a few people.
Can I have some water?
Oh, thank you. Mm-hmm. I saw a few people performing.
Okay.
And one day I'm like, you know what, let me try this thing out. And that was pretty much it. So I tried it out and everyone's like, oh my God, perform again. I'm like, wait, what? Really? Okay. Mm. And it took me like over a year before I could actually say, yes, I am a spoken word artist. Because for me it was, I don't think I am. I just, you know, I'm good at this acting thingy.
Mm-hmm,
so
mm-hmm.
Because for really poetry and then doing spoken word is really all about your delivery.
Yeah.
So that was it for me.
The very first one you did, what was it about? Like, did you rehearse, or you just came?
I didn't rehearse. I had written a blog post about dreaming of a romantic Lagos.
Oh.
So I basically just kind of changed it around a bit and then went on stage and started this whole I dream of a romantic Lagos. And pretty much after that, everyone wanted to hear the whole romantic Lagos thing.
Yes, because Lagos is not romantic.
Lagos is definitely not romantic. So
how dare you people?
Have you ever performed at the, I think it's called the Music Lounge?
I have performed at the Music Lounge, yes.
I think I remember.
It depends. I have, yes. Yeah. Okay. I have performed at the Music Lounge. I've performed, I'm like part of the family for Tarawa.
Yeah. Okay.
So I do a lot of Tarawa shows.
Is spoken word, how do I put it now? Is it a viable?
Oh, profitable sort of.
No, it's not.
Oh,
so yeah. It's more issue.
Most people do it
as like a hobby.
Well, now a lot of people are actually like trying to get an income out of it.
Yeah.
For people like me, it doesn't really pay the bills much. It's still very much for passion, but we are hoping that as time goes on, it would become profitable. Yeah.
Okay, we're going to take a break. I know Zainab, I think, has a question. When we come back, we'll find out what it is. And then our topic of the day will be dissected. See you in a moment.
Hi guys, welcome back to The Spot, and it's time for us to get into it with our topic of the day. I did have a question before. I was just going to make a point when Ebuka asked about whether or not spoken word could be like a viable career path. And I was going to say that I think it can lead on to certain things, because I have some friends who are spoken word artists that have put out spoken word albums or written books and gone on to do talks and so on and teach and stuff. So I think it can bring in some cash.
What sorts of events would a spoken word artist perform at?
Besides poetry music. Events? Music events.
Yeah.
I think it really just... General, I mean, I got married in December, and I had my friend Wana perform.
Yeah. Wana has an album, doesn't
yes,
she?
Yes,
she has
yes.
a spoken
and
word
my
album.
Friend, and it was kind of like, okay, you have poetry at your wedding. I'm like, well, of course I have to have poetry at my wedding. So Wana performed. So I think any event really just depends on...
what tone you want to set.
What tone you're trying to set, yes.
Is because
yes.
Titi Lokwe Shonuga,
exactly.
She performed at the inauguration for the president. And you wouldn't think... Oh, spoken word at an inauguration, but you know, you make it work because her poem was
exactly.
about Nigeria and new beginnings.
And then there are different poets for like, just like how you have like different types of music, you have different types of poets and what they do. So I tend to do all the whole romantic, boy meets girl kind of stuff.
I remember. You had just gotten engaged.
Yes.
And she did a poem about her guy and how she had like met all of these other guys who weren't really working.
Okay,
and then
now
finally...
she remembers me.
Oh my God. And she was holding a glass of wine during her...
I know you... She loves wine.
Oh my
so
God.
If there's wine involved,
yes,
she
will
remember.
Yeah.
Oh, awesome. I love that poem.
Yeah.
Wow.
So, I tend to do a lot of those.
Okay.
Then you have the likes of Ify Paul, who does a lot of... political.
Okay.
So
okay.
he has this piece which is about 7 minutes long, and it's about the history of Nigeria from beginning to date.
He's done half of it on
exactly. So every time he does it, I'm like, how do you even remember all that stuff? So it really just depends on the kind of event.
Has your poetry, I'm sorry, I know because you're newly married, so has your poetry, I mean, you talk about romantic, but like have you gotten new poems out of your experience so far? It's only been a few months, but you know.
Well, I've been writing.
Yeah.
I think eventually in a few months I will
perform.
Debut. I'll make sure he doesn't find out. That's it really.
Okay. So our topic today is procrastination. And that one thing that we all hate and still so much time and effort. We're going to be talking about it from several different angles, what to do, how to deal with it, and what, you know, some of the effects of procrastination as well. Mm-hmm. So for those who don't know, I do have an official definition, which is, and the official definition is interesting. Because when I think of procrastination, I just think about putting things off and not coming back to them. But the definition reads, procrastination is the avoidance of doing a task which needs to be accomplished. It is the practice of doing more pleasurable things in place of less pleasurable ones, or carrying out less urgent tasks instead of more urgent ones, thus putting off impending tasks to a later time.
Yeah.
So if it's not urgent, it's not procrastination.
Yes.
Don't give him excuses.
So it was a pleasurable thing as well.
Don't even do it.
Yes.
No.
I need it.
Less, less pleasurable. Urgent. It's either or. It's not just urgent. Because of urgency. Yes.
So I assume we're all procrastinators here.
Sadly, everybody has a little bit of procrastination.
Different levels.
Different levels. What's your level?
On what it is, though. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, what do you procrastinate most about, and what do you procrastinate least on about?
I think working out is the one I always procrastinate.
can I do it in the evening?
And it's like, I'm tired of tomorrow morning.
I'll wake up early.
I have to get to work. I'll do it in the evening.
How do we actually convince ourselves that we're going to go, like, we will get it done. When we clearly know it's not going to happen.
We're just fooling ourselves.
I'm going to start waking up at 4 a.m. and I'll get it done before I have to go and go to work and whatever. But it's like,
the alarm will not come
and
you'll just press dismiss.
Because
you know you're not doing it.
I think it depends on how badly you want it to the end. So, you know, there are certain times when I have, like, a deadline and I have been pushing it. Like for days. Eventually, I'm the one that's up at 3 o'clock, like, oh my God, I have to finish this. Yeah. So that's it. When it comes to working out, when I start feeling my joints hurting, like, yeah, then that's when we start working out.
What do you procrastinate least on?
Least.
Like, what's the thing that you, maybe because
you can just
you do it, you just do it. Even if
writing, maybe.
I'm writing, mostly
what do you
writing.
Write? Because we didn't really talk about what you write.
Well, I do stage plays. Nice. I for the most part, I help people like write shows and stuff, so like script write for shows. Mm-hmm. But at the moment, it's stage plays. I have a blog called Single and Giddy, and it was staged.
Oh my gosh!
Everything
is coming back to me.
It's all coming.
So I had one that's been made into a series.
Yes, it's been made into a series. It was staged.
You can ask her to be a friend.
a stage series or TV?
TV now, but it was staged Interculture.
I saw that. Ijoma was in it, right? Was Ijoma in it? Wait.
No,
hold on,
it was Meg Tawa, Lily Bioma, Timmy Charles Fadikwe.
So where was Zainab available?
See, this is not where you should lobby for roles.
Ignore her.
I know you now, so that's all that matters.
But do you really know her?
Exactly.
Well,
don't be a hater.
I can get her number, so that's okay. So that's been basically it. I have a few stage plays that I'm writing for, hopefully maybe this year or next year. But that's it. So that one definitely I don't joke around with that.
All right, we're gonna take a quick break now and we'll come back. Sheila will still be in the house, but we'll find out from Zainab, Lamide, and I what our procrastination habits are like in a moment.
Welcome back to The Spot. We have been joined by Sheila, who is a writer, a spoken word artist, and we've been talking about procrastination. And before the break, Ebuka talked about us sharing our own procrastination habits, and I guess I'll start. I think that I am a procrastinator for certain things. I don't wait till the very last moment, but I do put things off. I put off working out. I put off certain things. I edit a magazine as well. Mm-hmm. So not a lot of times, because now my boss can be like, you do what? sometimes I need to contact people for interviews and things like that. I'll be like, I'll do that this evening. And then I remember all of a sudden. I think it's also part of like planning. Mm-hmm. If you're not the best at like writing things down, you tend to forget. And then you're just like, wait a second, is there something? Oh, it's midnight now, I can't call. Mm-hmm. So yeah, stuff like that, I think. Medium procrastination, not too bad, but not that great either.
Okay.
You?
I procrastinate a lot with keeping in touch with certain people. So I'll make a plan that I need to call this person, that person, just to say hello. I'll even put reminders in my phone. So the reminder will go off, like call granddad every 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Right? I'll put it up and then I'll say, I'm like, gosh, I'm just in the middle of typing this thing, and if I don't really finish typing it, then I'm not. So let me set another reminder. And I just never get to it. And they get really angry because they don't understand that I'm trying.
No, you're not trying.
It's not working. So I'm like, know that I love you, like, and I'm constantly thinking about you all the time, but I'm just sorry.
You're constantly thinking about them all the time, you pick up the phone.
It's a terrible habit. What do I least procrastinate with?
Wine.
wine, anything that's money related.
Girl, yeah.
If money is at the root of it, it is at the top of my to-do list.
You are motivated.
I am motivated.
So what you're saying is grandpa needs to be offering you money so that you can call?
Granddad, if you were, you know. Yeah. And then relationships too.
You procrastinate how?
No, I don't.
Oh, you don't? Yeah. You don't, when you're, wait, okay, I need to understand this.
If you're into someone.
If you're into somebody,
you're like there.
Yeah. Oh, if I'm not, I'll see you calling me. I'll see you sending me messages too. Where are you? I'll let him know in like 3 days. I'm so sorry.
She's
if there's anyone
the
that I haven't gotten in touch with in like
just
3 days.
Just know now.
Just know that I'm sorry.
So I'm not, she's not sorry. She's just not that into you. Hey, Buka, and you?
I procrastinate about a lot of things. But I think the one that would be like 9.5/10 on the level of extremes would be replying emails.
Ah!
Yeah.
Gosh. Why? Did you send him an email?
Because she's guilty as well.
Oh. Guilty too.
And it's really bad because sometimes it's even something important for like work. And I tend to... I don't know why emails are such a problem for me.
Do you...
You could send me the same thing by like WhatsApp and probably get a reply almost immediately. But having to now, because I feel like emails are so formal and sometimes I'm not in the mood to be
drafting
it. DSR. Like, I'm just saying,
it's
you
actually
know.
Quite annoying.
So that is really bad. That one is really bad. And I get a lot of, but I
is it all types of emails or like
most
nonsense
types
ones?
Of emails. Most types.
Okay.
Yeah, it's really bad. What did I procrastinate about? Television. If I like something, I will make out time to watch it. And I don't miss it. Which is really, I mean, I don't know if it adds a lot of value to my life sometimes, but it's just fun stuff maybe.
It's funny, I just realized that I procrastinate with returning calls. So I always say, I'll call you back, I'll call you back. And I do that to my mom all the time.
Don't do it to Mama. They get so pressed. But then you said you were going to call me back.
Yeah, and then she calls me, the last time she was like, look, Sheila, when you say you are calling somebody back, call the best.
Yes.
I was like, sorry, I was driving. She's like, hey, you as what you say.
Yeah. So have you been driving all the all week?
No, right.
You didn't
so
get out.
I always try to remember,
know,
like,
most,
call.
Most of our mothers are more phone call
people.
Right,
than
yeah.
My mother's
so
definitely,
they
yeah.
expect, you can't be sending a typing text, no.
No.
Call.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Calls.
I have
calls
that
about everything.
Too,
so
I'm like that with people. Like, I don't say I'll call you back if I don't really have an intention to. You know, I'll just be, we'll speak later. But if I say I'm going to call you back, then I have to make a mental note because then I'm like,
I just forget.
I'm so bad.
I just forget.
I'm just remembering everything.
You just remember everything. All your sins.
Oh, and it makes people
feel
bad.
I feel like
bad,
it's even worse
it's never
when
intentional.
You say, let me call you back.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh. So which means it's soon.
Yeah.
And then 2 days later,
you still haven't made
no,
that call.
There have been times that, like, a few days later, I'm like, oh my God,
I didn't call.
This person called me and I didn't. And I'm like, hi. Like,
I know I owe you a call, girl. You won't even believe. Oh.
I know, right? So that's really where I'm like, oh gosh. Oh.
Has it happened to you where you said you call someone back, you don't? Then, like, maybe a week down the line, you now realize you need something from the person.
Oh, yeah. No, I tend to smooth them over.
So you just call. You're like, hey,
no,
I'm just checking
for
up.
For that, you send a message first. Well, just send a text. Like, hey, I was just thinking about you.
Yeah,
how are you?
Yeah.
It happened to me a few days ago.
Yeah, you have to have a
this
way
person,
to have that.
I kept saying, I'll call you back. And then I needed them for something for this show, actually.
Oh, wow.
And I was just like, damn it. I was like, hey, how you doing? I'm long time. Now, wow. I didn't do that stuff. And I'll send a message like, so please can
you yeah. Like, hey, so now you need me.
Yeah, that's
I have a few friends that do that to me though. So yeah.
And you know you always know what the person is like.
Yeah.
So
I'm like, yes.
There's people
okay.
that call
and I'm
like,
waiting to just say what she wants.
I don't
wants.
Even
yeah.
No, I just say, what do you want?
Let's get it over.
Just say what you want.
Well, I like to entertain. I like to entertain the small talk. And that's when I now remember everything I want to talk about. Like, oh yeah, so do you know this happened? So I'm like, okay, fine.
Let's talk about Syria and your credit. Oh, what did you call me for, by the way? Oh, yeah, now what do you want? Your question
yeah, finished. I'm that. So when the person eventually says, I'm like, oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then if it's someone that will maybe upset me, I'm like, you know what? I'll call you back. And that's like another week. So
what are the things that you, okay, I think it's time for us to take a break, but when we come back, we'll find out what the things are that other people procrastinate about that irritate us the most. So please stay with us.
Hi guys, welcome back to The Spot, and today we've been talking about procrastination. Lamide wanted to discuss things that people procrastinate on that annoys us.
Yeah, like when you've given some, maybe if you've given someone a task to do or something like that, someone that's, you know, someone that consistently does something that procrastinates about something, and it just gets on your nerves like the most. For me, it's probably like, you know, when you're living with someone, it could be a roommate, a flatmate, a boyfriend, a husband, a wife, whatever. And everybody has like their household chores or tasks they're supposed to do. The thing that gets on me the most is when you know, for example, okay, you're supposed to take out the trash because the trash guy comes every Tuesday, the trash people come every Tuesday, but you leave it there. And then like, you now see like the truck rumbling down the road, or you hear the truck rumbling, oh, it has already passed your gate. You're now having to carry the trash. You'd be like, ah, come, I take it. Because the thing is full and overflowing. Like, that upsets me. When there's stuff in the house that you have to do and everybody has their role and you don't do it, or you leave it to the very last moment.
What are you trying to say, Lamide?
No, I'm just saying.
Who are you subbing in your house?
I'm not subbing you. I've had housemates before.
When yes. I didn't live here. So you're staring at one of them. So what are you trying to say?
Well, chill. We had different. come on. Actually, what was it that you did when we were living together that used to get on my nerves? Nothing much.
You
still
stay by. Give me the evil eye.
Like, she used to cook me breakfast, so I'm just gonna be nice to her.
Anyway, things that I don't like, people who don't return my calls.
You don't return calls?
It's funny how you think we procrastinate. You don't like
people who don't return my calls, number one.
When they
and people
money
who
too.
Like who, okay, so I might call them and their phone's busy, and they like they just don't call ever back. Call back. Yeah. And I'm like, you saw a text message that I sent you, and which I'm asking you to do something. And then you call me 3 days later, I didn't get the information of something. Why are you calling me 3 days later? Why didn't you call me the day when I was supposed to send it? Mm. So those are the little things.
Okay.
I get to host events quite often. So sometimes you have the agency or whoever the event person is saying, I'll send you the event flow or whatever the event is about.
Okay.
And it happens quite often where it doesn't get to happen until you walk into the event and say, so this is it. And at that point, it's the sort of event where maybe you needed something prepared, or you had a dress code you didn't know about and you dressed wrong and stuff like that. Yeah, so that's, and then because at that point, the client doesn't know happened. It's just you looking competent. So with that.
That's never, I think for me, it's if you have like a role that everything else kind of depends on you. And then, so you slacking means everybody else slacks.
Yeah.
So I have that problem, like sometimes like, with my job that pays the bills, since writing and poetry isn't paying it yet. So I give instructions like, okay, especially to like the security men, like make sure there's diesel in the gen and make sure we have extra.
Ooh.
And then, so I'm in the middle of something
and then
lights goes off. And then,
there's no diesel.
I won't tell you that time.
We used the last one yesterday. I'm like, what? Excuse, why didn't you tell, why are you telling me now? So that really kind of upsets me.
True.
But other than that, I'm married to a chronic procrastinator.
Oh.
So, yeah.
How's that going?
I love you, darling. But yes, it can be a bit frustrating. So when we first started dating, I just thought, you know, this guy just doesn't care. That's the problem. But I realized that it's just, he always just moves things. Mm-hmm. So I'm the constant reminder, like, have you done this? Then 5 hours later, have you done this?
Yeah.
And he's like, okay.
I'll
so
do it now.
You guys balance each other out then?
Yeah, yeah.
I always look at it as, because my wife too is very, if she's going to travel today, she'd probably pack in January.
Yeah, that's me.
And I'm more the person who will pack like 2 hours before the trip. So I'm like, okay, maybe I bring spontaneity here and you bring the you can balance it.
I'm pretty sure it's frustrating for her.
So he's spontaneous, right?
Yeah, he's
more
very
spontaneous than you.
Yeah, I'm not. I'm far
from. So procrastinators might be spontaneous. It's not always bad.
Okay.
Okay. So we have a chef that's not here but she cooks for us elsewhere, and then she sends us videos of it and just teases us with
it's always so heartbreaking.
So let's check out Friday Foods today.
Hi everybody, my name is Uzo. Welcome to Friday Food. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to make a very simple dip to go along with store-bought plantain chips. Sometimes it's no fun just eating the chips alone. So a nice dip that has some healthy elements like vegetables will be very, very good to go along with your plantain chips. So you only need, well, 5 ingredients. You need tomatoes, diced as finely as you like them, some spring onions, white and green parts chopped, and then in this bowl I've got natural yogurt and a little bit of salad cream, and then for the kicker for me is bacon, and this has been cut into very, very little pieces and then diced. And on all you have to do is mix the yogurt and the salad cream together. Instead of using all salad cream or all mayonnaise, you can lighten it up with the introduction of the yogurt, plus our own local yogurt, which costs less than 500 naira a tub, is pocket friendly as opposed to the Greek yogurt that you find in the stores, which can cost as much as 2000 naira for a small tub. So the salad cream and the yogurt are in the bowl. I'm going to add some tomatoes and the spring onions. And again, the beauty of this is, it's the weekend. The beauty of this is, you mix ahead of time and don't stick it in the fridge. And then when you have guests come over, when you're ready to eat it, just whip it out of the fridge. You don't have to start making it at that point. And then I'm going to add the bacon. There are all sorts of very interesting things that people do with bacon these days. And I have tried everything from like bacon pancakes to bacon cupcakes. Okay, so stir everything together, make sure that everything is evenly coated. Let's see, nice and simple. And so when you want to eat, you simply take your plantain chip, and I like the sturdier plantain chips like this because these dips have body to them, so if you take this little skinny ones, they'll likely break. And then just simply, and then scoop. Simple, delicious, definitely addictive. So make sure that you're very serious about your portion sizes, or else you're going to eat a whole bag and you won't know what's going on. So until the next time I come your way again, I'd love to hear from you. Have a wonderful weekend.
Thank you, Uzo.
I don't procrastinate about
weird,
food.
That's a
actually,
weird
I do. You do?
I do. Yeah. I do. I do and I don't, in a sense. Like some days I'm like,
cooking,
oh, I should eat something. Cooking.
Okay. Cooking, I definitely
do. I like to cook. I like to cook.
Because
sometimes, you know, sometimes you're like, I'm really hungry. And like, well, maybe water. Just because, you know,
really?
to start chopping things.
Oh, wow.
Like, I'll just drink some water and then wait for, like, my mom to come. I'm like, Mommy, I'm hungry. So, no, you were at home all day. I was busy waiting for you to come back so that you could come and help me cook something.
Yeah. Right. So, how about we offer some tips to people
after the break, maybe?
Okay, after the break we'll do that.
Okay, so we're going to take a break now. When we come back, Zainab will be giving us some tips on how to deal with procrastination. Please stay with us.
Welcome back, guys. You're still watching The Spot. We're about to round up the conversation. Before the break, we did procrastinate. Some advice for you, which we're going to try and do now.
Gosh.
Or should we wait till tomorrow, Zainab?
No, let's do it now. So here are some tips to overcome procrastination. Number one, be aware of the habits and thoughts that lead to procrastinating.
The main thought is, I just don't want to do it.
Exactly, that's just it.
So I don't know how much you want me to think. It's not really deep. I just don't want
but
to
what
do
leads
it.
To that? So for instance, somebody who who's constantly procrastinating with their emails might also be somebody who likes to, at the moment they get in their computer, they like to visit a lot of blogs first, whatever.
Yeah.
So that's like priority before they get to the emails. So acknowledging what you like to do before might help you find a better solution to the problem. Seek help. For self-defeating problems such as fear, anxiety, and so on, difficulty concentrating, poor time management, because these are all factors related. Yeah. Evaluate your own goals, strengths, and weaknesses, and priorities, because sometimes we do want to do grand things and big things, but it's not, we don't have the capacity to do it.
Yeah.
And that results in us procrastinating. Restructure activities of your daily life.
Yes.
So in the morning, if you're very awake and assertive, then put all of your priority duties there. Whatever works with your daily structure.
Energy levels.
Yeah. Modify your environment.
Sorry, can I just say something about that point?
Mm-hmm.
I have someone I'm friendly with that was a chronic, like, really bad procrastinator, very bad, but she started writing things down and scheduling her time that. And she said it really, really helps, and it's something that really helps, like if you have a calendar, some sort of app, whatever, and there's so many apps now that help you with that. Literally, she schedules in the time she looks at Twitter and Instagram, like she's like, okay, Monday from 5 to, or every day from 5 to 5:30, Twitter and Instagram, 6 to 6:15, Facebook. She says that way it helps her, you know, sort of set out what she's going to do with her day and then not spend hours, because you're just here and then you're now, or you're on YouTube and you just, before you know it, it's been 2 hours and you have a brief that was due and
you
haven't
done it. What if she's like Zainab, who knows the schedule, but she's like, yeah.
Well, I mean, discipline. You just have to talk yourself in. Exactly,
you turn off your reminder. They call grandpa.
Don't come for me. Use me your example. For calls, not work.
But writing definitely helps. I have a notebook where you write things down.
Modify your environment and make them work friendly. So don't try and do things.
Sorry, I'm sorry.
You don't get to walk out in the courtyard sometimes, don't you? That's a modification of environment.
I say don't you? I've never been to jail.
So if you know that you have something to do, don't sit in front of the TV and try and do it. This is for Ebuka. Before we go, would you mind doing a little read for us? Just a tiny one.
I knew you were gonna do that.
It could just be like one stanza.
I'm shy. You're not shy. It's just three of us now.
Okay.
I need to take a seat for this one.
I need to take a seat.
And Ebuka doesn't normally take a seat for anything.
Really, I can't even figure out which one. I have too many that I've worked on.
Just do something. Anything nice. I'm sure they're all nice.
Actually, no.
Wow.
I think I'll probably do... I'll save you from the mushy stuff. So I'll probably do one. It's called The Friend Zone. I did at the Music Lounge. I don't know.
The Friend Zone.
The Friend Zone.
All right, let's go. They can do it through this camera.
Yeah. Okay. Let me tell you the many ways that I know you, the many reasons that I love you, and the only reason that I hate you. Wait a minute, I know you think I sound crazy, but just give me a moment. I really want to tell you the many ways that I know you. See, I know you like the back of my hands, like every inch of the room that I can see in the dark eye. I know that you don't like football, but you tell everyone you support Man U because you only love the winners. And, okay, mom's stuck.
That was good.
I'm mixing my lines up.
This is how we do it.
It's okay.
That's how you do it.
I can do it all over again. I could actually do the whole thing over.
Okay.
So if you remember my lines.
Okay.
Yes, I remember my lines.
Is it Arsenal fans that jazzed you when you said
be quiet? Yes. Be very quiet.
Okay.
Let me tell you the many ways that I know you, the many reasons that I love you, and the only reason that I hate you. Wait a minute, I know you think I sound crazy, but just give me a moment. I really want to tell you the many ways that I know you. See, I know you like the back of my hands, like every inch of the room I can see in the dark. I know what makes you happy and what makes you sad, like your mom's Sunday lunch or fried rice and dodo makes you very happy. And driving in traffic in the rain makes you very grumpy. As a matter of fact, it makes me grumpy too. I know that you have no favorite color, but you tell everyone pink just to start a conversation. And you really don't like football, but you say you support Man U, is it Arsenal, because you only love the winners. I know that you lie sometimes, like that one time you fell down the stairs, but you said you fought our big boys that gave you the scar on your head. Well, I know you were just too shy to say so. I know the mood you're in by the music that you listen to. Fella, when person don't find your trouble. Am I because you are Africa's number one chairman? And Sinatra? Well, Sinatra is for those days that you're stuck at work, because really the best is yet to come. Hmm. So those are the many ways that I know you. Now let me tell you the many reasons that I love you. I love that together we're like five and six, like white on rice, or is it brown on rice? I love that you know my deepest, darkest secrets, and I never have to worry about hearing it from anywhere else. I love that you know I hate cooking, so you always take me out for suya and chardonnay. And those are the many ways that I know you, the many reasons that I love you. Now let me tell you the many reasons that I hate you. I hate that even though you know me, you cannot tell that I'm in love with you. I hate that every time your boys comes around, you always go, oh, who's she? Oh, she's my friend. Because really, we're not related. We're not by blood, not from state. We're not from anywhere around. I hate that you don't notice that I wear a lot of blue because you like the color blue. And every Friday, I prepare an egusi and ignon because it makes you happy too. So these are the many ways that I know you, the many reasons that I love you. And the only reason that I hate you is because you have me in this box forever as your friend, but never as a lover, a shoulder to lean on, but not a body to savor. So even though I know you, even though I love you, I hate you because you have me stuck in this thing called the friend zone. Woo!
Love it!
That's your Chardonnay, man.
That's all you make.
You're not calling.
I love it.
I don't like this guy.
Oh, guys, we really
you have a good thing.
Like this.
They will cook for you on top. God. She doesn't like cooking. No, she's cooking.
She's cooking. She pounded it. Thank you so much for that.
Oh, she was awesome. Thank you guys for having me. Loved that too. We have to go now. Yeah. So, guys, we'll see you another time for more fun on the spot.
That was fabulous.
That was awesome.
That was really nice. Thank you. Love it. Please sign our wall of fame. There's chalk in the blue candle holder.
Yes. Watch the glass.
I'm like the sun.
All right, okay.
In the morning.
So this is your Chardonnay, yeah.